Welcome to OnSign TV Expert Tips. One of our recently updated apps is the Sales app, which carries a more impactful visual kick than its simpler version. The simple version of the app is best for items presented with a transparent background, like this. Meanwhile, the new and improved Sales app makes better use of full resolution images and has a more modern approach to introducing and shifting between the items. So let's set it up. Create a new Sales app, with the modern in the title, by the way. Just like the simple version, this app is data feed enabled, so we need to check the requirements for our data feed here. So our data feed must contain the product name, item price, and an image. We can also optionally add currency and unit. The unit column will describe the amount of the item you're selling. So if you're selling a product per pound, kilogram, or per bag, for example, let's create these columns. Create a new data feed, go to manual, or you can import it from source if you prefer. The first column we need is the product name. Set the type as text and include a note for future users if you think that's needed. Up next, we need the item price, which needs to be the type number. Up next is the image column, and we'll set the type as image. I'll also add the optional columns here, even though you don't have to if you don't want to, the currency and the unit columns. Both of these are type text. Let's whip up some sample products to experiment with. Let's take earphones for a start. Fill in these. In the unit section, you can put each here if you're selling per product, or if you don't find it necessary, you can just leave a blank space here and it will not be shown. Meanwhile, if you're selling something like fruits or vegetables or something of a greater quantity, let's say strawberries, you might be selling them per kilogram or pound or a different unit of choice, a bag, for instance. This is enough for a preview, so let's save the data feed and head back into the Sales app. Choose the data feed we just created. The columns will be automatically assigned, but double check them since we have several text types and it's possible they might get mixed up. First, let's preview the app to see what we're working with. So this is what the animation will look like. You can change the default text, which says sale. Let's change it to special offer. You can even replace the text with your logo if you want to. Here you can play with the color schemes of the app. You can ensure it matches your brand colors if you want to. And lastly, you can tweak these settings at the bottom to disable animations or the intro, for example, if you think that they take up too much time. And there it is. Your new app is ready for use. That's it for this expert tip. I'll see you in the next one.